Raptor 1 versus Raptor 2. Are there major differences? Starbase 2 update. What's the latest info at the Cape? Terran R. Promising or just another dream chaser?
What about it? Go for launch.
We're go for launch. Looks like it's handled.
Ignition sequence start.
My name is Felix and I am your host for today's episode of What About It? And as always, there's been a lot going on in the space industry lately, so let's dive right in. Raptor 1 versus Raptor 2. SpaceX is in the midst of switching to the Raptor 2 engine, and at the same time, they are building out the pads that will very likely see a Polaris 3 crewed Starship flight, a Dear Moon all-civilian lunar expedition, and Starship's Artemis moon landings in the next few years. The annually held Charo Days are a two-nation fiesta and an annual four-day celebration held in Brownsville, Texas, in cooperation with Matamoros, Tamaulipas, Mexico. Celebrated for the first time in 1937, it is held to recognize Mexican culture and honor the Charos, or the dashing Mexican gentlemen cowboys. So much for the history lesson. This year, though, it was also a symbol for SpaceX's gratitude. Musk was asked if he'd want to attend the Charo Days this year at the recently held Starship update at SpaceX's Starbase. He said yes, and he stood by his word.
I will be there.
All right.
SpaceX built a parade wagon and showed up. And Elon brought a Raptor 2 engine to show to the public. Chief, the YCAM operator, of course, was on site and took some beautiful pictures of what's to become Starship's future soon. Seeing these pictures, it's probably the right time to do a first detailed analysis of what's changed between Raptor 1 and 2. Are there any significant differences? Let's find out. We have Alexander Swan's renders of the Raptor 1 engine on the left, and on the right is a picture from Charo Days and from February 26th. Even at first glance, we can see that a lot of the plumbing and connections have been removed. Raptor 2 looks cleaner. This is partly due to SpaceX eliminating all sorts of sensors needed for a prototype engine. On a prototype, you want to get as much data from the engine as possible to develop it further. On a production engine, that isn't needed that much anymore. Its powerhead, that's everything above the bell, almost seems to be only half the size of Raptor 1. This is a bit misleading, though. Most of the essential parts actually got bigger. The methane turbopump grew. Comparing the main methane inlet on both engines shows almost double the diameter for the methane intake. The nozzle throat is visibly wider. The oxygen turbopump likely grew too. This is to reflect the higher power output of the engine. Raptor 2 has around 245 tons of thrust at this stage. Raptor 1 was at about 185. That's a whopping 32% increase in thrust compared to Raptor 1. We can also see that many of the joints were converted from flanges to welds. This gives the engine more durability. On a prototype engine, you want everything to disassemble if needed. On a production version, you have more confidence in the construction to use more welds. The electronics were completely redesigned, much more compact and integrated. SpaceX has redesigned the gimbal system. On Raptor 1, we had the gimbal joint attached to the engine. It has been moved to the ship on Raptor 2. This likely makes swapping the engines easier. Raptor 2 shows three main improvements from the outside. It's more powerful. Almost every pipe on it has a larger diameter. It's much more straightforward. The shift from prototype to production engine is in full progress. And finally, it's built for quick maintenance and replacement. Ground handling the engine will likely be much easier compared to Raptor 1. A massive shout out goes to Alex Swan for providing us with these incredibly detailed Raptor 1 renders. Go check out his Twitter account, he's currently working on a refreshed Starship and a Raptor 2. You rock! On we go with a progress update on SpaceX's Starbase efforts at Kennedy Space Center. Greg Scott and Farial Mohan were in the air for Lab Padre doing a flyover of SpaceX's efforts at Kennedy Space Center. Patreon links are in the description. Enable Greg to do more flights in the future if you're interested in SpaceX's progress at the Cape. Farial, Greg and Lewis, you rock! If we compare these pictures with what our YCAM took in December of last year side by side, the progress becomes apparent. Hangar X. The dominant structure in this picture is thought to be for Falcon 9 maintenance and refurbishment. It's likely though that if SpaceX has to accelerate its timeline for the Cape due to the FAA not greenlighting Starbase in Boca Chica for orbital flights anytime soon, at least part of all this will be used for Starships as well. Another view released by Greg Scott shows the whole complex, and it's needless to say that things are evolving quickly at the Cape. A steadily growing workforce is expanding the site further and further, and the plans for the site are even bigger. Toasty Croissant, a talented young 3D artist on Twitter, has invested the time to superimpose SpaceX's future plans onto Greg Scott's pictures. And this gives us a good view of what will be built. The site is divided into two main complexes. Hangar X for Falcon 9, and behind that, further down Roberts Road, a Starship complex. Two high bays, similar to the ones at Starbase, and an extensive maintenance and production facility. Those buildings will ensure SpaceX's future projects at the Cape. Polaris 3, SpaceX's first crewed Starship flight with Jared Isaacman amongst others. Dear Moon, Yusaku Maezawa's flight together with 11 other passengers around the Moon. And Artemis 3, SpaceX's Starship Moonshot. SpaceX also seems to be building foundations for what looks to be a tank farm on site. In current pictures by Mauricio from RGV Aerial Photography, those same pads can be found under all the horizontal tanks. Since a tank farm at Roberts Road would not connect to Pad 39A, where SpaceX is currently planning to launch Starships in Florida, it's unknown what those tanks could be used for. One possible scenario could be pressure and stress testing capability at Roberts Road, giving them some R&D capability at the Cape and for Starship development. Greg's pictures tell an obvious story. SpaceX is ramping up its efforts at the Cape more and more, and the intent is clear: establish a second Starship facility. The same can be seen at Pad 39A, SpaceX's future Starship pad at Kennedy Space Center. Commodity tanks, piling work, and more groundwork. SpaceX will likely erect a Starship orbital launch pad next to the existing structure, probably a Mechazilla launch and catch tower too. SpaceX is almost ready to use a completely redesigned Raptor 2 on their Starship prototypes, but they are missing a launch site due to the FAA still blocking Starbase. It's certainly good to see them ramp up their efforts at the Cape, even if it won't be needed for prototype testing down the line. Why is completely for free?
Yes!
But if you liked what you just saw, and if you're interested in even more and higher quality content, let me give you the good news. All that's needed from you is a like and maybe even a subscription to the channel. Of course, if you're willing to help us out even more, we'll be cheering for you, and we are ready to give something back in return. Become a channel member or patron to receive Discord access and ad-free and early releases of our episodes, or buy yourself a new shirt on the Why Wear merch store. We all very much thank you for your help. You rock. Terran R, sooner than expected. Next up, we have Relativity Space and their Terran rocket family creating some headlines with promising announcements. I've talked about Relativity Space before. Heavily funded by big industry, they are currently working on their Terran rocket family in cooperation with NASA. Entirely 3D printed and fully reusable Terran R, the rocket to come after Terran 1, promises to be a more miniature but equally revolutionary Starship. And Relativity Space is not standing still. They are in full swing of testing their Aeon 1 engine, which, similar to SpaceX and Blue Origin, runs on methane and oxygen. 9 of these are supposed to propel their Terran 1 rocket first stage upwards. And Terran 1 is in full development as well. Primary and secondary structure is fully 3D printed. First pressure and structural tests passed successfully. Milestone after milestone, Relativity Space is getting closer to its first launch. And Terran 1 won't get many launches either. It's comparable to SpaceX's Falcon 1, which saw a total of 4 launches before being retired. It's the technology demonstrator, meant to show their investors that their plan has chances of success. Just recently, they announced that Terran 1 will launch this year, and their mission name for that first launch is GLHF, which stands for Good Luck, Have Fun, and is the traditional greeting of opponents in video games before a match starts. Relativity Space's goal is to compete with SpaceX's Falcon 9 down the line. Not much besides the 3D print aspect and full reusability is known about Terran R, but Relativity Space seems to be very confident. One customer is already secured, and according to CEO Tim Ellis, the whole team seems to be very determined not to disappoint. Terran 1's first launch will not carry a payload. Launch number 2, if number 1 is successful, will carry a small NASA satellite, and launch number 3 will carry a payload from a yet-to-be-disclosed customer. The current plan is to utilize a 9-engine configuration of their Aeon-1 engine on the first 3 flights. After that, it is already supposed to be replaced by a 7-engine configuration of their Aeon-R engine, which in the end will also power their Terran-R rocket. Developing a 9-engine configuration as the initial project certainly is not an easy task. According to Ellis, this path was chosen to tackle the complex problem early on to gain the needed know-how swiftly. Founded in 2015 and with more than 400 employees by now, Relativity Space definitely is one of the more serious competitors when it comes to new space companies. And with more than $1.3 billion of secured capital from so far 2 funding rounds, the industry seems to agree. Terran-R is still set for a first launch no earlier than 2024, but this is only 2 years away. The aerospace industry keeps changing, and efforts from many different developers are ramping up more and more. Already established players like Rocket Lab, with their Neutron rocket equally set to launch for the first time in 2024, are revolutionizing the market more and more with exotic-looking concepts and new ideas. It's impossible to say who will prevail and who will not, but it is certain that we're looking at a very promising future for the space industry, not only from SpaceX. After many years of little change and innovation, sometimes decades apart, the aerospace industry is becoming what at least I have ever imagined it should be. Full of new ideas, unique concepts, and with a combined force of thousands of bright engineers, we're heading straight into a bright future for spaceflight. Today's video is supported by Brilliant. I've said these words many times, so let's find out why Brilliant was my first and still is my monthly sponsor. Brilliant is the perfect sponsor for an educational YouTube channel like mine. Watching videos and reading text is a great way to gain a basic understanding of subjects, but to take your comprehension to the next level, you need to actually do it. Brilliant is all about interactivity. Their classes and lessons are full of experimenting and experiencing the topics on your own. And this is the most effective way of actually understanding and not just memorizing something. How does heat flow work? One of the most critical topics when designing a rocket engine. What is pressure and how do different forces react to each other? Ever seen a starship blow up? What is a reflection and why are some surfaces reflective and others not? Starlink streaks in the night sky. Almost every topic in STEM is somehow connected to the space industry. Logic-based thinking. Geometry with real-world examples. Mathematics. You'll find all of it on Brilliant in an easy-to-understand way that makes you crack the most difficult topics in no time. That's why Brilliant has been a continuous sponsor of What About It for more than 2 years now. To get started for free and try out everything Brilliant has to offer, visit brilliant.org/whataboutit or click on the link in the description. The first 200 of you will also get 20% off Brilliant's annual premium subscription. Today we are delaying the supporter shoutout to the next episode on Friday. We have an important message from Team Space. We do not support war. We stand for peace and unity, and right now support is needed. Let those who suffer know that they are not alone and that we all stand united under the stars. Let your voice be heard on social media everywhere. I've often said that why is not about politics. Today it is about freedom and unity. The whole team stands for Ukraine and humanity, and we express our strongest disagreement with the Russian leadership. Let there be peace. Stay safe wherever you are. We are with you. Charo, it's Charo, Charo. Tamaulipas. All right. Yup. Toasty Croissant. It's such a great name. Cool video here.